Hello there guys, in today's video we're going to be talking about what is the difference between match betting and arbing. Now this is a bit of a grey area for some, especially me, because I'm still a bit confused about the difference. One side of the coin, I think they're very closely related. The other side of the coin, I feel they're two different disciplines totally. And that's what you guys are probably thinking. These are two different disciplines, match betting's this and arbitrage is that, which I agree. My definition of the difference between match betting and arbing is match betting is revolved around offers. Now that can be the sign up offers like these, it could be reload offers like bet 5 get 5 free with this offer, it can be other promotions such as the bet 365 2 up promotion here that I did a video about 2 days ago, it can be other offers like horse racing refunds like this video here I done 3 days ago. It can also be each way extra place promotion like this video here I done 3 weeks ago, and all these kind of things. These are the differences that define match betting away from arbing. Having said that, years ago match betting did just used to be called arbing. Now I've seen on some match betting websites they'll say match betting has been around since 2007 and all this kind of talk, which is incorrect. It's been around since even before exchanges, because how we used to do it is go on teletext and back one odds that were higher than other odds and make the money like that, which I'll show you in a minute how to do it. It was only when companies like Profit Maximizer by Mike Cruikshank came around this kind of time that publicized this word match betting. Before that, it used to just be called arbing. Now there's several different ways how to arb. If you come on the front page of my website, there's this little picture here. By the way, this website's getting changed next week or the week after, and it's going to finally start looking good. If you click on read more, I've got a long article about this, about match betting and arbing. Now there's 5 different types of arbing that I consider 5 different types, although there's a lot more in betweens, you know, like such as minimum odds guarantee arbing, there's straight arbing, which I'll show you in a minute. There's naked arbing, which is a very risky advanced technique. I'll leave the link in the description box about that, where I used to do £2,000 ARBS, unbelievably. I know you're going under your breath straight away now. But this, by the way, this palpable errors, this is what leads to a lot of these showing by error sometimes. Now, when you go on an odds matcher and you see this sea of ARBS like that, wow. Sometimes it feels like, why can't I just abuse these accounts? Is there any accounts there that I just don't respect and I'm just going to batter the life out of these? That's what you can do in those instances. If it's a company that you don't respect, like the Marathon Bet here and some of these others that are not going to be good for any offers, that you think, well, these don't provide any offers or that don't provide any offers, so I'm just going to take these ARBs. In those instances, in my opinion, it's worth arbing. But there's several kinds of ARBs that you can do. I will show you on, I've got match betting calculators, by the way, which are here. I've got several more up here. This is a 2-up calculator. These are all free to use. These are my actual own calculators. They're not hired from Odds Monkey, like on a lot of sites you'll find. I've got an each way calculator. I've got a rule 4 calculator for non-runners. And I've also got a fractions and decimals calculator, which are coming handy for newbies, I think, trying to convert fractions to decimals. This one here, because it is a bit overwhelming at first when you need to convert fractions to decimals, and you could just pump it in here. I've even looked at things, random odds, like how many times do you see this? It's usually in horse racing, 85 to 40. Now we'll give you a manual ARB. So let's say we went onto one of those sites that I showed you here that have got one of these massive ARBs, and we're going to manual ARB something. So let's say we've seen 5.5 about this horse here, Hebrides, and it can be laid for 5.2. Now this is what's called underlaying. I only learnt this a few years back, what it was called. I mean, I'm a master at this trade, but I didn't know what the terminology was. Now with this underlaying method for £100, we stand to win £30 if this horse called Hebrides wins, or win nothing, win or lose nothing if any other horse wins. Now, what you'd need to do to secure a lock-in profit is what's called overlaying, another terminology I learned off of these match betting places. So if we overlaid this, usually if you was normal, you'd go on a match betting calculator, press a button, it spits it out to you. So £106 is not that. It's 105.75 nearly. 105.77, that's what it is. That's what the overlay figure is. 105.77. You might think, why don't you just go on a match betting calculator, mate? It's a lot easier because I like to see the variations in there. Like I said to you, what was that figure again? 577, right? If you typed in 100 there, I can see I can win £30 there or lose nothing. But if we typed in 105, we got to 105.77 in the end. But you might want to go halfway house. You might want to lay, I think I'll fancy a £2.50 profit out of that, but win 19. And there's other things you can do. When you have this 19.50 green, you could also put in running bets. You could lay odds on, like £10 at odds of 1.2 would lose you £2 from this if it didn't win. But if it looked like winning and didn't win, you'd win £10. But this is a bit advanced. I'll do this in another video. I have provided other videos explaining about this. Now, I've done a video before called Arbing Gubbed Accounts, the 5 most common ways. Now, when we're talking about gubbed accounts or having a set of match betting accounts, like I said to you about this analogy, where you've got a sea of red on there, and you think, wow, some of these accounts I don't need. Now, the software to use for this, if you had a bunch of accounts there that are random accounts, we say Marathon is the most random of these most well-known ones, yeah? Because they're not really random, but they're less well-known than your Paddies, your Bet365s and so on. But with these arbitrage softwares, they spit out far more bookmakers. A lot of the Eurozone-based bookmakers that are accessible and legal to open in this country, you can find with these. Now, the cheapest arbitrage software you're going to get is BetSlayer, and that's for a reason. It does the job. By the way, these arbitrage softwares, they're a lot more advanced and technical than match betting software. It's only because they're faster, they've got more programming required, and they do more functions. And the next one up from BetSlayer is Rebel Betting. They've got 3 products, by the way. They've got an arbitrage product, which they call sure betting, just like they do. Sure bets. This terminology is used more in America and Eurozone. So if you ever see sure betting, it means arbing. So they've also called it sure betting here with Rebel Betting. They've got a value betting product as well. So there's a link for a free trial down below. BetBurger, you're getting more into the specialised arbing territory here. With BetBurger, is a lovely piece of kit, but it's expensive stuff. With BetBurger, you can look at doing middling, which I'll do in another video. It's an advanced arbing. It's not hard to understand, but it's called middles, same as Oddstorm. Now, what I like about Oddstorm is they do a subscription here for one day for $7. What am I talking about? €7. Now, the reason why I mention this is if you've got these accounts where, especially if you're multi-accounting, and you've got a set of accounts, set of Marathon accounts, a set of Intertops or whatever that's called, all these random accounts, set of these other accounts that pop up more so on these odds matches with the Arbing software, then you'll think, well, I don't mind abusing these accounts like this. And you can just set about getting a one-day subscription on Oddstorm and then just go ding, 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 just sit there all day long. And surely you're going to profit if you do that. You might have to have a nice bit of bankroll behind you. But I'm just giving you some food for thought there, guys, on top of this basic video about what is the difference between match betting and arbing. Now, that's my opinion anyway. If you've got a difference of opinion of what the difference of match betting and arbing is, please tap away below. Also, I think personally match betting is a stupid word, only because I was used to it being called arbing. I used to do arbing even in the 1990s, where they had things called teletext, and what we used to do is back something higher and then something higher on the other side, so you dutch it like that. So let's say, for example, you got a two a two horse race, say for the sake of argument. You've got an FA Cup final where it's only two outcomes and both bookmakers were offering odds of 2.1. It's a simple process, and you used to find that a lot on teletext because there weren't these softwares around to detect, so the bookmakers couldn't detect quickly, oh, we're offering 2.1 and also bookmaker B is offering 2.1. And that's how you used to be able to arb off of teletext. But you still have to be fast because you'd have to ring them up and say, oh, can I have £200 on at odds of 2.1? And then, of course, with bookmaker B, can I have £200 at odds of 2.1? By then, it might be cut. You had that kind of situation going on. It might be cut to 2.0. So you still stand a small bet. It used to be a lot harder work, but possible. This is my argument when people say match betting's only been around since then. Well, in fact, it was around since the 90s, if you consider Dutching as that. Anyway, I'm rambling too much, guys. There'll be a shorter video out tomorrow. Please like, comment, and subscribe. And I'll see you later.